We must continue. I will start, but I want to make this announcement so that people will understand. You know, the zoo, they are cracking their brains, which they don't have anyway, because everything they pay millions and billions for everything. Listen attentively, please. What they are coming, the plan they are using on us. Listen. Somebody said the other day in Onisha Market, because again until Fuma, so that you understand. Listen attentively. Because here we expose to you the whole plans of our enemies, their modus operandi. You know what happened? Say one young man, bought something, started buying something in somebody's buka, and buying things. After he finished buying, time to pay, the woman gathered everything, give him his wares. And the woman said, pay my money. The boy said, what are you saying? I said, my money now. Your money is 4,000 naira. They say it's 4,000 naira. You know what the boy said? The young man said, I am ESN. We are here fight. I've been in the bush. I'm in the bush. We're in the bush fighting for your security, for your survival. Aren't you enjoying what we are doing? Look at no more raping in the bush. And you are asking that I should pay you this and that. The woman said, but this is my way of survival now. So how can I? He said, I am a member of ESN. So I don't need to pay. I need to come. As he was talking, he started manhandling the woman. And people were watching. So after one other man came rapidly. Say, what is happening? Because people gather, in our place now, I don't know, people have become so cowardly. Now, one other man came out very clean shaven. Came up and asked the young man, what is happening? Why are you beating this woman? He said, look, we are inside the bush protecting them. And I come to buy something. I don't have money. I shouldn't pay. Because we are sacrificing our lives for all of you. So I shouldn't pay. They said, the other man said, okay, is that so? He went out. Within a few minutes, he came back with the other men and they carried the young man. Go. And took the young man and entered inside the car and went. And that's it. Let me tell you one thing. And they said, the narrator of this thing started saying that, look, some people started talking many things against ECN. No, otaka ndi ECN wagesie jida. Otaka biafra wagesie abia. Hey, mbakwa urukwa like this, we stop it. Mbakwa, how can he buy no pay? Hey, blah, 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 blah. Oh, chineke, I say, look. This is why we need to sound this alert. Look. Do you know what happened? This is another strategy by the zoo police and military. Listen. Ndinakpa nkata, they are Igbo people. Because the Fulani have conditioned these people always to make a plan for self-conquest. Do you understand? For self-conquest. Do you know that the people that even pushed for, during 1967 to 1970, during the war, the people that were vehement on crushing Biafra, they are Biafrans. Azikiwe was one of them. Okpabi Asike is one of them. There are some of them inside the Biafran military. They are the people. The people say no. Don't stop. They are the people bringing plans in order to kill us down, to kill us. Let me tell you what these people want to do. Any person you see that come out on the market buying something, say I'm ESN. He's a zoo police or a military. He's not. No ESN can come out on the streets, start telling you, I mean, ESN. No, please. You know what they want to do? They want to bring backlash. They want to spoil the mind of the whole people, the whole population. So that now the population will be against ESN. Listen, do you know what Hope Uzodinma, do you know what the governors in Igbo land, Igbo Biafran land, do you know, even Wike, do you know what they say? They say that they will use money, that about Niger, they will use money to bribe those people, to cut those people off, to cut our people off from the leadership. Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. So that you know they will neutralize everybody, bribe everybody into submission. This is what they are doing. This is what they want to do, and that is why, as our leader have warned, and as we are telling you, any person that Hanes and Ibo one meeting with ESN with IPOB, Iga, you die. Listen, what we are doing, this is not a local champion or childish game. What you are doing is not childish game. So that Kega Kwao, you go to the meeting to get contact. You go, they will kill you. Any meeting direct, it will be directly to the leadership or with the leadership. International. What you are doing, we are not here to joke or to do so that you will get at least contact to start having a contract. Gone are these days. People don't understand what we... Gone are these days when they will use money to, you know, to bribe and to do you this and that or contact. And you come. Okay, we want to have peace meeting. You, which kind of peace meeting, for goodness sake? Which kind of peace meeting? Where? They will lodge you in Sheraton Hotel, in Abuja Hilton, in this. So because you never even sleep in a 4-star hotel before, talk less of 5-star or more. That's why you know that is all these things. Akuriogologo. That is what kills many of our people. That is what compromises them. Akuriogologo. So what am I saying? Let me continue in this. Any person that come and finish buying something from you, selling or doing anything, after they start shouting, I'm ESN, this I'm Iyeni Lao, these are planned work. The person that come, the people that came collecting, they are all the same. What their only goal, what they want to bring is negativity for people to turn against ESN. So that your people, will, you know, they have gone. They will go and do it another place. So that to steer negativity against IPOB, against Mazi Nnamdi Kanu, against ESN. That is what they want. That is the only thing they need. Do you understand? Do you remember when they went to rob a bank and put a flag? That one is too open. People are wise. Immediately, even old man and woman sleeping. Once they hear it, they say it's Nigerian government, they know who. Yes, IPOB don't do like this. So any person that come buy something from you, buy a goosey, buy a bono, buy this and that, after you tell him pay me, start saying I'm ICL. Hold him. Don't allow him. Don't even say call police. Hold him. Tell him. Where is the ESN? Oh, yeah. Don't allow people to come and take him because they are all the same. What they are, you know, we are 7 steps ahead of them. It's only the gullible that these people can deceive. I'm telling you, if you want to be deceived, only when you want to be deceived, you know, people that are looking for faults, only gossipers. What they want to create is they want to create confusion between the population and ESN. Nothing more, and IPOB, because they know that the people, everybody, 90-something percent of Biafrans trust IPOB, trust ESN. So what do they want to do? You know, this abduction is not enough for them. They want to cause this, bring disenchantment between the people, so that now the people will turn against ESN. I will talk. If I look at, I saw the ESN, they are hand on Obobom, they are at the back of my house. They are in that bush there. That is the only thing they want to do. So our people should understand the game plan. Do you Do you are you hearing me? This is what they did during the 1967-70 Biafran War. What they did to our people in the River Rhine, the Ajaws, many of our people there. You know, they will use, Nigerian soldiers will use Biafra, wear Biafra uniform, Biafra camouflage, and come to a community, an Ajaw community. And the people will welcome them as their own. After they start slaughtering them, not knowing that they are Nigerian soldiers, but they wear Biafra uniform. Now, in order to spoil the mind of the people, you know, this war, don't think that war is only shooting gun. No. There are intelligent actions in warfare. Intelligent actions in the warfare is more potent than even shooting of gun and this and that. You know, with intelligence, you can even win a war. So we are warning our people. I think my voice is being heard in FM stations, via FM in our land. Please. Onye ọwụna bịara n'ahịa gochaa ahịa sị gị sị ya nyenụ m ego ya sị gị na iji ana m ego awụ m onye ESN anyị nọ n'ọhịa na-eche ọnụ nche na sacrifice ndụ anyị ọnụ ịchọ ịna m ego mba jide ya ọ bụrụ ESN ndị awụ ndị ochie ọ ndị Nigerian police ọ Nigerian mili jide ya wụrụgodi onye Igbo jide ya don't stop that sentiment jide ya ọ ndị Igbo jide on do shika on the government in the police and the army oh ha na men here ha na this guy so one said before you know it he ga hose one person bia bia kporo ya say ah ke ihe na me ya say ah no lekwe na wo monye ese ESN am me gro ma here o train na me go but e jiru me go in no here na eche ndia nche every time eh onya ga say okay ha bia bia kporo ya oru ha aguna. Their job, once they come out from there, their job is finished there. Now the reaction of the people, many gullible, we start talking against ESN. Without knowing that he our ESN. No ESN is outside. All are inside the bush, taking care of our forest, taking care of the terrorists, the bush meat there. That is what we are doing. We stay. And do you know what they do now? You know, most of them might say 70% of those arrested, incarcerated, they are not Igbos. It's lie from the pit of hell. You know why he's saying this? This is my preamble, please. You know why he's saying this? Because he's having backlash from the people that, I'm from Olu. I have had opinion, I called personally different people. And everybody, even in Olo, even in our mama, everybody want to see Hopus Odema killed. That is what I'm telling you. So, why he said this is this. So that people will say, ah, no, okay, na India name here, Wukandibo, also Wukandibo Koji. So, he's doing a good work. This is, they are playing mind games with you. He is abducting our people, boys and girls, killing them. And he will tell you, no, they are not evil. It's life from the pit of hell. Let him provide those people. Let him parade those people and provide. You know what they used to do now? Anywhere the angels or non-government go do something, go do their work, go evangelism. Now, in order for the Nigerian police to cover their shame, these unknown gunmen will finish everything and go their way. Now, they will arrest people around. Anybody they see, they will arrest and start parading them. Oh, we have seen these are the unknown gunmen. Hey, we captured them. Do you know what they are doing? They are covering the shame, their shame. Because, you know, people have been saying, why is police? Police have gone, they are crying. So it's a shame to the Nigerian government. This is meeting the held, and they concluded this. Anyway, you know there are some gullible ones. If unknown gunmen are doing work, now they will be there. No, it doesn't concern me. They work like zombie. Instead of running away, because you become a victim of what you don't even know. You'll be there. No, it doesn't concern me. I don't know. They will kill you, or they will capture you and go. Before you know, they will chain you. They will handcuff you and put one gun there. Oh, these are the unknown gunmen. These are the IPOB. We capture them. Who will hear your voice that you don't know what you are going to your work? Who? They will bring Chinese television. They'll ask you, how many have you killed? How many police stations have you bought? You don't even know nothing. You don't know nothing. You are not even a family member of indigenous people of Biafra. Although you're a Biafran. Yes. So, anytime you see the angels or you hear them walking, run away. Run. Walaka. For you not to be collateral damage. Because the whole people they are abducting, parading, they don't know anything concerning. Many of them, most of them are not even IPOB family members. Active ones, I'm telling you honestly. Many of them are there. No, we don't know. Do I know anything? You come the pass like zombie and they will catch you. They don't know. The Nigerian police don't know anything about whether you are... They consider everybody the same. Do you understand? They consider everybody the same. This is what I'm telling our people. This is what we are telling our people to understand. So that you don't become victim, collateral damage, victim of your stupidity. Please, let me repeat. Any person that comes to your shop or in the market nearby and buy something, he don't want to pay. What is the reason? Say, I'm ESN, we are protecting you. Call. The whole people around, gather, hold him. Jitanya, see, no one knows him. No agent of Nigeria. No, you know, these are the people that don't merit pity. Before you know, if you people, the way you know, once you hold the person, you see others coming. Oh, we are police. Okay, let's carry him. They are together. They are working on your brain for you to start turning against ESN. We are here to make you understand the secrets, the intelligence that you should as a human being. That is why we tell you that common sense is necessary. Don't judge everything immediately on face value. Stop talking. Blah, 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 blah. No. Don't do it. You have to reason. Subject everything to reason. Sovereignty of reason. Now you reason, you say, what? Yes, and you never see yes and start coming openly. Then they push. Our leader used to say it. On Radio Biafra here, we used to say it. That they are inside the bush. Why will this one come? What is his mission? There is something he has in mind. There is something. That is how human beings behave. You reason. Not the slightest thing you carry. Hey, up on the agent. Hey, Ndi Biafra. Hey, yeah, welcome, Ndi Biafra. Because you're stupid. You're foolish. You are an animal. That is why you conclude. Because you don't reason. This is what they use in destroying the mindset of our brothers in the River Rhine during the war. It's one of the things they use in destroying their mind against Biafra. Oh, this Biafra. Oh, they are killing us. Oh, it's them killing us. They don't know that they are playing mind game with them. I said, this generation of Biafrans, we have no equality. Is it Almajiri? All these plans that are being hatched is not Almajiri. Eh? It's the same saboteurs. Is our saboteur brothers hatching this advanced plan they are using against us? Play mind game. Because they vow to turn the people against ESN. That is what the Fulani spent money. You know, they are spreading money anyhow today. Ask yourself, why is it okay now? Money full of, so the governors can spend money. They can buy people. They can pay people to give information, right? But there is no electricity. Everything is costly. Why? Where then? They owe people arrears. They owe people salaries. If you ask, they say no money. But they had money to. They have money to splash around against ESN. Don't you see that there is something terribly wrong? That these people, they are there for themselves, not you. They are there for the people. I mean, for themselves, not for the people. We must continue. In the southeast, now they have divided. Southeast, okay. Governors are yielding their political turf and mandates to secessionists, criminals, and subversives who think they can exterminate federal presence and northerners from the region and achieve dubious political goals related to 2023 or break away from the country. Okay. Their first division. Second, in the southwest, you see. Now, no more south. They divide this, you know. But for them, everything is the north. You never hear them. You never, in this write-up, I didn't see where they say, we in the northwest, in the northeast, in the north center. Do you see how they out, you know, they out-manage everybody? They trick everybody in the south. And God Almighty. Okay, in the southwest, elected leaders and pampered ethnic bullies are closing ranks to provide a front that helps to do what we want, or we leave the country strategy of the marginalized leaders of the southeast. Okay, you see, here they recognize that the southeast are marginalized. Do you see it? Now they are trying to tell the Oduduwas that, you see, all of us are marginalized southeast together. Not be only us. Do you see how they play mind game? No, I don't like people saying, oh no, the Fulani, they don't know anything. I don't like it. Them don't know, not knowing how to speak English doesn't mean that they don't know. Politically, in their own way, they are very, very shrewd and cunning. They are smart in political moves. Look at all this write-up, the way they write things, and it matters a lot. Because you that is reading it is having an impact in you. When they talk about North, you never hear them divide, say, describe Northeast, describe Northwest, describe North Central. They, at the beginning, they say the Southerners want to divide the North, but they cannot. Now, it is them that have the authority that to divide the South, as usual. Now, they come to that division, they describe Southeast, they describe Southwest, now they are describing South-South. Say the South-South is squeezed between fear and uncertainty, and its leaders are gambling that they can benefit from further weakening in federal administration, and the North if it rides along with the rest of the South. Wait, why can't somebody challenge them and say, why are you calling us Northwest, Northeast, North South? And you never call yourself South East, you call us Southwest, Southeast, South South. And you never call yourself South, Northwest, Northeast, North Central, which is the normal thing. Now, why are you doing that? You see, because our own politicians in the South are stupid, honestly. And the people, in short, they allow themselves to be divided. Look at, they have divided Southeast, Southwest, and South-South. Do you understand? The forum extends its hands to groups that genuinely believe that Nigerians should demand and design the type of country we want, and should not wait for people we elected to set the boundaries and conditions of our existence. And that is what you are doing. Because when you say, the Southerners are falling for the secessionist agenda, of which you cannot give them. Who are you to give them? You know, our leader said, We, the Satanas, make themselves even cheaper, low life. That is why the Fulani, they are talking to using everybody as they want. Because when we demand the restructuring, we are demanding it from who? If you are an equal to, if you are in one country and you are equal, who you are demanding it? It's for you to set a person and say, look, we either do this or we have consequences. That is how to do things. Or we walk away. But for you demanding, we demand. Edwin Clark said, no, I went for one Nigeria. I am not for secessionist. Tinubu say, I'm not for secessionist. Who are these people? They are one person, one individual. How can we, God Almighty, Chineke. These people, they believe that everybody in that Nigeria, the whole population are dummies. We need to, sometimes, it seems you have extraordinary power to destroy everything. Because these people, what they need is destruction and nothing more. They have bitten more than they can chew. How can somebody, one person, Edwin Clark, I am there for one Nigeria. Who then let there be referendum. Let there be referendum. That is one person, one vote. In the case of United Kingdom moving away from EU, did you see any politician come? Okay, they gave the whole population the right, their right. Because one politician or two or five of them cannot decide the fate of millions of people. This insult in Nigeria to God who made me is too much. It's better for everything to perish. Because these people, they have taken everybody for granted. Because they see people as very cheap, low-life human beings, lower homo sapiens. That is why they are dealing with people like this. Somebody will have the audacity. Millions of people will be agitated, say, no, we need referendum. Only one person will come. No, I'm for one Nigerian for that case closed. What does it mean? It costs everybody to animals. And he because he's eating and dining with Katana Liang. He thinks that he's larger than life. He is more important than, he's more than maybe 20, 50, 70 million people in Biafra land. And other millions, tens of millions in Oduduwa land. Diagaba said he's for one Nigeria, he's not for, he's one voice, one vote. Do you see the substandardness of a black race of Nigerians? Do you see it at work? Otherwise, in order to prove their point, what everybody is expecting or should expect is do what? Okay, let's put this into referendum because this agitation is too much. I am a politician, I'm an elected official, a politician, but my electorates, people that elected me, they are agitating. Let us put this thing to test so that we know whether they can win or we win. I am for one Nigeria. It's your right, no problem. But do not cover others. Only because you are one person. Oh, you are a governor. Oh, you are a senator. Now, whatever you talk, that is a final. Who? Said by who? We have passed that era of extreme and complete zombie from all of us. Today, what we are, you know what we are doing? Imagine I'm the kind of started it. You know, Uncle Gro. I remember when we were small. You know, during the hammer time, you will gather leaves and, woods and just put it. You light it. You know, it will start by small smoke. You know that small smoke? It will start, you start blowing it, oofu, 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 oofu. It will be expanding. Only the leaves will be burning. Before you know now, little by little, it will be catching the wood, the main wood. Once it cuts the wood, finish. There you know that it will stay. That is what our leader have sown, that seed. He have lighted the fire. So you cannot quench it. All these people that come, I support one Nigeria. Okay, all of you, the politicians, one person, one man, one vote, one woman, one vote. That is it. That is the world we are. During the election, the governor, does the governor vote twice? Because he's a governor. It's one vote. Highest, he vote with his wife and the eligible family members, children. Finish. He will get two or three or five votes. Finish. And the population, they vote, they decide. Not you. So why is it this madness of this one will come? One Nigeria. Nigeria will not exceed. We are for one Nigeria, Edwin Clark. Tinubu said we are one. This is your meeting. You have been having your one Nigeria and enjoying your one Nigeria. No electricity for the people. You will have a set of the art generators in your homes. You have swimming pools, mansions everywhere in your homes. And the people say, no, enough is enough. And you want to continue forcing all these things, you know, as a larger than life people. No, it cannot continue working now. No. It cannot continue like this forever. It's impossible. People are opening eyes, and that is what we are telling people. Open, shine your eyes, so that you understand what is going on in the world. Stop allowing all these politicians to continue deceiving you. They are doing what they are doing with impunity because you are stupid. They see that you are stupid. Do you understand? They see that you are stupid. You don't know your left and right. So they are deceiving you. And you are clapping for them. That's it. Time has gone when one person will come and one governor. Oh, I'm your governor. So what I agree is for you. Say, no. In the case of freedom, in the case of this, no. Nigeria has been existing since 1960, the so-called flag independence. We don't have electricity. We need to try another. We need freedom so that we build the country of our tests. That is the way to reply them. Not, governor has said, no, because people are stupid. Governor say, no secession, no division. So what are we going to do? Who is the governor? It's only one person. Ask him, even among his entourage, if they organize, referendum is organized, most of his entourage will vote for division, to freedom. I'm telling you honestly, most of them. Because many of them that are serving us, they are serving their governors just on fear. If the governor comes, their entourage, if the governor laughs, they will laugh. Just inside their mind, they are insulting their governor because they know he's a bastard. Inside, they're only playing lip service to smile. Oh, governor is happy, so everybody should smile. All of them say, ha, ha, ha. But look at, just in their private conversations, two people, you see them insulting the governor. Say, look at, I'm not here. Eh? What you are doing? I'm not here. Killing people. They know. We need to change the way we reason. Our leader used to stress this way, the way we reason. That is the difference. That is why you want to go to Japan, South Korea, Australia, Europe, America. Why? Can't you ask yourself, why? Are we not the same human being? Why is it that these people, they have constant electricity? You don't have no electricity. Why is it that life is nothing in Nigeria? Because of the way people reason. That is the only thing. Simple. If people rise up, if majority of people in Nigeria are enlightened, they will pursue all these idiots called politicians. Who is Jagaban? Who is Tinubu? You come, they cut off his neck. Oliver Cromwell did it to King Charles. Many of them, they say, who are you? You are enjoying because the people never rise up. When people rise up, you run. Remember Ensars, it just snaps a little example, and they worked hard to thwart it. We are going for our freedom, and nothing will prevent it. This is where I'm going to stop. Tomorrow is another day. For me, from here, it is simply good evening.